Hello guys, so in continuation to the previous video, in this video we are going to see how to install Ansible. We will install Ansible in one of the machine that we will create in AWS. So if you want to know how to create AWS machines, you can watch this video thoroughly, or also you can go through my AWS basics videos in my channel. So without delaying further, let's get started. But before that, I'd like to request you to go through my previous video on Ansible, because I've spoken about theory. I've spoken about the basics of Ansible in my previous video. So without delaying further, let's get started. So I'll create one new instance now. I'll use Ubuntu machine. I'll use the basic one, which is ready available. I want two machines because I will also show you how to configure host machine as well. So I'm going to show you two ways of configuring host machine. One using keyless authentication, one using key-based authentication. Let's quickly create the machine. I'll allow all the traffic as of now. So let me quickly launch it. I have a key. Let's wait for the machines to get launched. Let's see. Okay, they are still launching. Let's name Ansible M means Ansible Master 1. Ansible host 1. So this is going to be my slave machine, and this is going to be my master machine. In slave machine I'm not going to install Ansible, only in this machine I'm going to install Ansible. So let me do a color coding in this so that I remember that this is the machine where Ansible is installed. So I'll make it green. So now, the very first thing before installing we need to do is update the repo. So we'll update the repository, the Linux repository. So I have steps jotted down. So my instances are ready and I have updated the repository. So all the steps I have jotted down here, and I'm going to run one by one, and I'll explain you what I'm doing. So I will add the repository for Ansible now. It means that I'm letting my machine know that from where it needs to get the Ansible package to install. So I think I have to restart the session or not. Yeah, it's hung. So let me duplicate it. So let's add the repo. So as we have added it, now we need to update the cache. So now we are ready to install Ansible. While it's installing, let's also connect to our slave machine. I already have Python installed in this, but if you don't have Python installed in this, so just what you need to do, sudo apt update, just update your repo. And then install Python by using this command. You can install Python. So I have Python, so I don't need to install it again. So let's go back to our master machine. Okay, Ansible is installed. Now how should we check if our Ansible installation is successful? Just check the version. How to check it? Ansible hyphen hyphen version is the way to check Ansible version. So if you see, we have Ansible 2.9.6. Now there are some important files which it has mentioned here. So one of them is configuration file, which is by name ansible.config cfg. So what actually it has, it decides that how Ansible will run. Suppose if I want to skip the key checking, then I can mention to skip the key checking here. So it will decide how Ansible will run in your machine. Okay, so all the Ansible configurations we can mention here. However we want to run the Ansible, we can mention it here. So there are some other files as well, but we will mainly concentrate on one of the file called config and another file called as hosts, which is our inventory file. So let's just quickly look at our inventory file. Where it is, it should be cd etc Ansible. Here you will find your inventory file. See, here you will find your host file. So our host file is the inventory files. Okay, and this is the config file. And here you also find roles direct, where you can create roles. So now if suppose I want to run any command in my local machine, let's take example of running a simple ping using Ansible in my local host. How to do that? Ansible hyphen m ping. Using this, we can run the command on our local host. We can run ping on our local host. So if you see, it has succeeded. So now let's quickly configure keyless authentication to one of the host machine that I have created. So now how to configure keyless authentication? What we generally do here, we create a key pair using SSH keygen. So our key pair is created. Now where is this key pair located? It is located in .ssh directory. If you see here, you get the key pair id rsa, it is a private key, and id rsa.pub is a public key. So what we need to do, we need to copy the contents of id rsa.pub and paste it to a file in slave machine. Where exactly we need to paste, we'll see it. So let's copy the contents. Let's go to .ssh directory here. So if we do ls here, we get to see authorized keys. It means in this file, whichever keys we are going to paste, the whichever user keys we are going to paste here, so they will be allowed to access this machine. So we can get the keys from master and then paste it here. So whichever keys will be here, wherever we have created those keys, whichever machine we have created the keys, so if we paste them here, then that machine or that user is going to have access to this machine without using any username or password or even the key. So this is how we set up a keyless authentication. So let's just quickly paste the key contents here. So always run these commands, like related to keys, related to changing the user configurations or creating users, you have to run through sudo user, means super user. So let's go inside it. And one important thing you need to remember is, you cannot have any space when you are pasting the contents from there. Not even a single extra space is allowed. Okay. Let's copy it again. And paste it here. So now I have pasted the contents of key file, of public key file from master machine to my slave machine, which is this machine. So I'll test the connectivity. If I'm able to connect to that machine using Ubuntu user, but without any key or password. SSH, how to do that? SSH, Ubuntu means user @ the IP of machine. Great, we are able to connect. So now we can easily connect to the slave machine without using any key or without using any password. So I'll exit from that machine. Now I'm in my master machine. So now what I'm going to do, I'm going to add that host machine to my inventory file. Now how to do that? We'll go inside the inventory file. So here you can go right at the bottom of the file. So I'm creating a group where I will mention the machine. Okay. So let me name the group as, maybe I want to create three different groups. A group which will have only production machines, a group which will have only test machines. So this group will have production machines. And within this group, I will mention the IP address of my slave machine. So before doing that, I will tag this machine. Slave, maybe slave one. Okay. Then I need to just mention the IP address of my slave machine in this parameter. Okay. So I'll copy the IP address, I'll paste it here. Now my inventory file is ready. So my inventory file has the details of my slave machine where I want to run the commands. So let's quickly ping to our slave machine. Ansible-m ping all. If I do this, now what happens when I say ping all the machines that are in my inventory file? So what actually Ansible does, first Ansible tries to search your inventory file. Okay. So it tries to search the file in different locations sequentially, which we will talk in our next session. So just remember, Ansible will look for inventory file and will pick up the host machines that you have mentioned in that, inside that inventory file, and will run the command whichever you want to all those machines. So if I do this, see, it has pinged the slave machine. Now why did I create a group in inventory? Why did I tag my machine? That we will see now. I can, if suppose I want to ping set of machines, if I want to run command in some set of machines, maybe I may want to run a playbook or a task in only in prod machines, then how will I do that? I will use the group name. Okay. If I hit enter, it's going to collect all the machines which are inside this group and ping them all. As I have only one, so it will ping it. Now suppose if I real-time scenarios, what happens? We always name our hosts. We use some best naming practices and we name our hosts. So we can also ping the machines using name. So that is why I have used tag. Instead of slave one, what we will have the name of our machine in real-time scenario. So I can, if I suppose want to run a particular playbook or command in just one machine out of that group, then I can do that using the tag.
How to do that? Using the tag, and it will automatically go ahead and ping that machine. So this is the importance of creating a group and creating a tag for the machines. So this is how we configure keyless authentication. This is how we install Ansible and configure keyless authentication with slave machines. So in next session, we are going to see how we can, because this is not a best practice. So that is the reason why we are going to see that how we can set up the key based authentication, because that is the best practice. We always use keys to authenticate to our machines. So we are going to see that.